What do you consider the most urgent issue facing Congress in the coming session, and how do you plan to tackle it?
The single biggest issue facing Congress is immigration. It's been that way. It's across the country. You know, Joe Biden, we have an absolute disaster at our southern border. He's allowed in millions of illegal immigrants, asylum abuse. That's going to be the biggest issue that our next congressman is going to have to face. And that's what I have the background and experience to help President Trump on day one. I've been to the border three times. I've been to Arizona, been to Texas. I know exactly what's happening. I can get to work on that problem on day one.
Two. What will you do to foster bipartisan relationships with your colleagues across the aisle, and do you consider that a priority?
I work with anybody of goodwill. That will be my job as a congressman, to work with people of goodwill. I do think there's areas where we can work in a bipartisan manner. One issue would be on Israel. You know, we had a vote just last week in the House where we had some of the most conservative Republicans join with some of the most liberal Democrats to vote against aid to Israel. Israel is under attack by Hamas, so I will gladly stand with Israel and work with like-minded Democrats who want to join me in that effort. I will stand with Israel today, tomorrow, always.
Three, what would be the topic of the first bill you sponsored?
Well, since I represent the 3rd Congressional District and I'm a Clemson graduate, class of 1993, I would hope about January 2025, the first resolution I would introduce would be one congratulating Clemson on winning another college football national championship. Having said that, on a serious note, you know, that's 8 months away. I've been around politics. 8 months is an eternity in politics. A lot can change between then. We can have new issues come about. So we'll see. We'll take it as it comes, but we will continue to focus on the border. That's my priority number one.
Four, what committee assignments would be most beneficial to your district and why?
Well, I've been around politics for a while. I've realized as a freshman coming from a solidly Republican district, I'm probably not going to get the greatest committee assignments. I understand that. I'm comfortable with that. I think the best thing you can do, in the words of a Clemson Coach Sweeney, says bloom where you're planted. That's what I would do in the Congress. But the biggest thing is, if I were elected, I would go up there and try to show my colleagues that I know what I'm talking about, I'm a value-added product, and I would work my way up. That's what the congressman from the 3rd District will have to do. They'll have to work their way up. Trey Gowdy was a great example of how you do that.